latest light made for running slash camping slash trail running. It's an IP66 headlamp which has as a main LED here in the center an XPG2 S3 cool white, and at the side you can see a pair of Hikri 4500 Kelvin LEDs and a pair of red 5mm LEDs. Now this light, as you can see, is very small and compact even for a running headlamp. It features a weight of 46 grams or 1.62 ounces, and the size are 53 by 20 by 27 millimeters or 2.09 by 1 by 19 by 1.08 inches. It has an integrated battery inside the body. It's rechargeable via this micro USB port. Here you have the rubber cover for the micro USB. The light still remains IP66, so it's waterproof until you submerge it for a prolonged period of time. The headband, what's the purpose of having all these LEDs on one flashlight? Well, simply put, this is the central one. The main XPG3 emitter will give you the most power. They are rated for 130 lumens, while the other ones, they are used for close distance because they have more fruit beam, and they also have a better tint for the Hikri ones. And the red ones, they can be used for signalization or also to better penetrate in the fog, or according to a popular myth, they preserve better night vision elastic. And it's the new style from Nightcore, which features on the inside, you can see it here, anti-slipping silicone insert that also helps avoiding the sweat from running on your face. And on the inside, sorry, on the outside instead, you have reflective inserts that helps you to be seen in the dark. The headlamp is attached to the headband with this plastic support, which allows you to tilt the light in some fixed inclination. When the light is completely vertical against its support, you can see there is this piece of plastic that prevents physical access to the switches, so you're not going to be able to turn the light on when you're going to carry it like this. The interface is pretty straightforward. You've got two switches that also act like a battery indicator, and the right one is the one for the main LED and the Hikri ones, and the left one is the one for the red LED. If you click once the right one, you turn on the main XPG3 cool white version, and as you press it again, you cycle through the three modes and then it turns off. Now if you keep press the switch from off, you get this neutral white Hikri fluid beam, while the left side you have the red LED mode. One click turns on the light at low mode, the next one within 5 seconds turn the red into high mode, and then you got this always within 3 seconds this flashing mode.
And now this is for the output, 128, 130 rated lumen at the XPG2 cool white LED, 123 for the red LED, and 50 for the high gray. The run temp chart for the XPG2 high is this one. The light is pretty regulated. There is a bit of decreasing brightness over the course of the first hour, but then the line stays on. And now the high gray, you can see the runtime is basically flat until the battery is completely worn, a bit over 190 minutes. And for the medium mode of the XPG2, the light stays flat for 11 hours. High mode, the battery is from 100% to 15% over the course of 2 hours, and then the light will stay on at that brightness for 5.5 hours more.
So, what are my thoughts for the NU17? Well, the light is well built and finished. For the price you're paying, it's a really, really good deal. Even if you just don't want to buy it for running, but you just want to keep it in the house to do some works, or you just want to gift it to a friend that you see that would need some quality headlamp, this will not break your bank, and you get a lot of lightness, compactness. And this factor is what often makes a difference between, for some people, carrying the light and not carrying. You might be giving them for free an expensive, big, heavy headlamp that runs great, has 5,000 lumens, but probably they're gonna leave it home. Instead, if you just give them something light, compact, they can also easily charge with a micro USB, this will probably be used much, much more. I like the fact that this light has several kind of outputs. This is a more focused one, the XPG2 has 3 emitter. If you need more fluid, you also have the high gray ones. They are way more fluid than the main beam. The high gray are also good for close distances, and the red LEDs, they can also be used not only for signalization, but they will help you a lot. If you run into fog or rain, the red tint will get through without blinding you. This, I use it a lot of times, putting it around my head, and even when I'm going running in the late afternoon or early evening and there is not complete darkness, I don't need a flashlight to see where I'm going, but this I will turn it on and I will put it around my head, on the back of my head, so other people and other cars can see. Thank you for watching. See you at the next one.